Right, folks, Jonathan here. When I was younger, I used to like to experiment, and I used to annoy my mother quite a lot. Seriously. I remember getting this old radio, and it used to have what's known as shortwave on it. And basically, you know, you could tune in and listen to sort of all these foreign radio stations, and you had lots of hissing. It was quite interesting, because you'd be listening, all of a sudden you'd hear, God knows what language it was, but it sounded good and the music wasn't bad afterwards. But what I've realised is if I actually plug something into the aerial, the signal got better. And then what I did, I'd have the aerial up like that, about, sort of, I don't know, you can't really see, about, I don't know, half a metre long, 50 centimetres or like 500 feet. Nah, joking. Actually, I'm not, but I'll tell you. So I realised that if you added a little bit of wire to the top of the aerial, you got a better signal. And I thought, wow, this is brilliant. So what I did was I cut a piece of cable. Seriously, I think it was about, I don't know, 40 or 50 foot of cable. It must have been. And what I did, I wrapped it to I wrapped it to a copper pipe in the house. I put it out the window and I wrapped it to a telegraph pole. And, you know, and I'll never forget because we had a guest house. The guests keep on having electric shocks when they were washing in the sink. Seriously. So anyway, right, that's by the by. But the reason for explaining that is I like to experiment. Right, now what I'm going to do now is I've got these, the twin CD players. Now one's cheap and one's slightly more expensive. Now a lot of people probably think, well, you know, the cheap one, the pitch control is going to be crap, and the more expensive one, the pitch control is going to be slightly better. I'm going to have a look and give my own opinion. So what I've actually done, if you imagine a twin CD player like that, and you've got an output from one side, which goes into one side of the mixer, and output from the other side goes into the other side of the mixer. Well, all I've done, I've got one of the twin CD players and I'm using one channel into one side of the mixer, and then I've got the other CD player and I'm using the other channel into the other side of the mixer. So in essence, I'm using both CD players, but I'm using one CD tray from each of the CD players. So I'll pause the camera and I'll show you, and then what I'll do one mix and I'll swap, you know, from either sort of, I'll put one track in the one CD player and one track here, and then I'll swap the tracks over like that. So hold tight. Right, there you go. There's the setup. Now what I've got this side of the top CD player in one side of the mixer, and this side of this CD player in the other side of the mixer. This guy here is the CD player that's relatively cheap, and this one here is more expensive. Right, so what I'm going to do, mainly the whole idea of this particular video, is I'm going to give my own opinion on the actual pitch control on this one and this one to see if there's sort of any difference. Now, I'm not wearing headphones, and what I've got, I've just got the mixer levels set at the equal volume. I've got the crossfade in the middle. So really what we're going to be doing is concentrating mainly on these, and then what I'll do, I'll swap the tracks over and we'll do exactly we'll do exactly the same thing. So here we go. And by the way, all being well, I'll stick the track titles to the side of the video in about 6 years. No, hopefully soon, very shortly. Hold tight, here we go. Let's turn it all down. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to press pause on both of them. I'm just going to, bit of an experiment myself here. We'll play this one now. Right, let's just start it off again, beg your pardon. Okay, let's try this side here. Okay, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take them both out, and then what we'll do, we'll swap the tracks around. Here we go. So we'll put that one in there, and we'll press, go to track 4, and we'll put that one in there, and we'll leave it at track 1. So, right, now I haven't touched the pitches, I haven't touched the pitch control, so I'm going to have to start from stage 1 again. So what we'll do, I think probably the best thing to do is, let's have a listen on that. Start again. Right, here we go. Alright, let's just pause the camera. What do I think? Well, it's like anything in life. If you pay your money, you know, you get decent. If you don't pay much money, maybe you don't get that good. But the thing is with DJ gear, what I'm actually finding, alright, we'll go back, say, and this is my own personal opinion. No one's telling me to say this. If they did, I would basically tell them to go and bugger off. Yes. But, and anyone else sort of my age group will understand exactly where I'm coming from. And that is that, when you know, years ago, really the industry standard piece of kit was the Technics SL1200. I mean, and still today, it's like, you know, the dog's doo-doos. But people were always trying to bring in new bits of kit. And to be quite honest, they weren't really up to scratch. Well, what I'm finding now is that companies are realising that they've got to do good. They've got to make, sorry, good items. Because at the end of the day, you know, us lot, who are the people who are going to be using it, if it's not very good, then we're going to think, well, what's the blinking point in using it? What's the point in even buying it? Because at the end of the day, when you're there in front of a crowd full of people, it's got to work. Now, my own personal opinion about those guys, and in a sense, I suppose, really any cheap CD player, and that is that it's got to be up to a certain standard. Otherwise, there's no point even making it. Now, these guys here, yeah, they're up to a certain standard, which is fair enough. I like the pitch controls. I mean, I can't really, to be quite honest, see any difference with them. I mean, I'm going to give them a good old bashing. They'll probably end up being knackered. No, they won't be knackered. Don't worry about it. I'm going to give them a good old run for the money. But from, you know, the fact that it's a twin CD player, it does exactly what it says on the tin. So there you go. Any more questions, any more queries, just sort of bung like comments and stuff like that underneath. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.